Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise, right?
Rolling. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bacon.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live, the skeevy assholes, that girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. I'd like to think my humor has improved with age.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health and safety violations.
Better living through chemistry. That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? I'm perfectly capable of waking up without you, you know. Eventually. One of these days, I'm actually going to use you to do my homework. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. Wait, what? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. God was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid, but then all the unicorns died.
87.9 FM The Satyr is supported by listeners like you. So, you know, feel free to donate money if you want to, anytime. Literally any.
Fun fact, shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child. Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong, and it was awesome. As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night. Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated. I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority. I bet Long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago. Man, I am killing it this year. Somehow I don't think Mom's going to feel the same way. How do I want to express my teenage angst today? I really should get going. Where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, Scourge of Arcadia Bay. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring? Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. I want Mom to be happy, but not like this. Not like this! Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie better. It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money. Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign. I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed. I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this. Dad, if you could see us now. Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. Ah, Mom! Back bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
I should call my phone. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. All right, phone. ¿Dónde estás? There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone, too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry. Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come. David's here so early. Mom calls him just a friend, but look at him. He's pretending he didn't just spend the night. And you never saw the condoms, Chloe. You never saw the condoms. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere. Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year. Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case. We're already supporting one. Thanks. Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back? Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room. Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. Hard to believe I was an eighth grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school? We're already supporting one. Thanks. From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me. It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so nobody's fault, really. Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist. Wait, those aren't Mom's keys. And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe? Mom's purse is pretty heavy. Shoot. I was hoping David could get a job on a container ship. To Japan. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Feeling trapped? Right there with you. Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
Haven't really felt like sitting down to eat since David started having dinner here.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk. How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food. Joyce Price. A.K.A. Mom. She looks as beat as I feel. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, what are you gonna eat?
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Come on, sweetheart. I'm sure David's waiting for his keys.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites the
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. Mom should date literally anyone else. tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay. No love for Chloe. Does Max picture me pathetically checking this mailbox every 2 seconds for letters that never come? Nah. School's hardly worth walking to. Wait, isn't that a socket wrench right there?
You deaf or just lazy?
You said you needed your socket wrench.
That's the 5/8 inch. I need the 13/16 inch extension, which is in the set, which is in the garage, like I said. Unbelievable.
Whatever. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? By toolbox, did David mean this, or did he mean himself? Fifty-fifty chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10. If it's in my garage, it gets my special treatment. What message does David really need to hear? Got it. Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for a friend. Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire. Damn. The stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache. David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted. If I don't bring David his wrench soon, he might explode. Not literally, but it's a nice thought.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Fine. Whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck!
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me? Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my friend. Burning midnight old again. What a beautiful day. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad. This isn't right. If Mom were here, she'd tell him to turn that junk off.
Dad, turn it up.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Hello, Black Hell.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class. Maybe this play won't suck. Maybe. How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? Meh. Well, at least not for now. It's nice that Elliot always wants to do stuff with me. I just haven't...
See you in class.
It's nice that Elliot always wants to do stuff with me. I just haven't been in the doing stuff mood lately. Skip Matthews, Blackwell's finest. He's not so bad for a mall cop. Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today. I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
So, I went to the mill last night. Caught Firewalk live.
You went to the mill? Wait, you saw Firewalk?
It was cool.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
What, like good music?
Preach it, sister. I'm in a band, actually.
No shit, really?
We're called Pisshead. It's not a big deal or anything. I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Yeah, okay.
Great. What did you think?
That was really good, man. If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Oh, right on. Awesome, Chloe, thanks.
Morning, Miss Grant.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today.
Science is all about discovery, Miss Grant. Guess you'll have to wait and see.
With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad. Look at it this way, Miss Grant. More art classes will keep all the smug, self-absorbed types out of your science classroom.
Articulate, as always.
Miss Grant, the least lame teacher at Blackwell. Wish she could get over the whole push me to succeed thing, though. Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere. What the fuck is that supposed to mean? Students at Blackwell have this herd instinct to glom up into little groups, like sheep. And if you just want to be alone, you get labeled like some dangerous outsider. Just like any other prison. Except now the prison follows you wherever you go, thanks to social media. I can't believe Rachel posted a photo of the two of us together last night. Am I still an outsider if I'm hanging out with Rachel Amber now? And what does it mean that hanging out was so awesome? Does that make me just the same as every other student here? Nah, fuck that. Steph and Mikey normally post up somewhere quiet in the courtyard. Huh. Weirdly, that makes me interested in walking on the stage. I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care. Principal Wells. Hey.
Miss Price, the sign clearly says do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
How many minor infractions and a major one?
This is no joke, Miss Price.
Who's joking? You've seen my math grades.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero tolerance policy. Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price? That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
All right, sir. I'll see you after school.
I'll count the minutes.
That guy's a tool.
Flowers always make me think of springtime, which makes me think of summer, which makes me think of getting the fuck away from Blackwell for 3 whole months. I love flowers.